How many WNBA players would you say are currently on the Iowa roster?
Wait, could develop to or like right now?
How many? No, not right now. How many people on the current roster will eventually play in the WNBA? When I say play, I'm not talking about, you know, being somebody that, you know,
like a Grace Berger, you mean?
Well, hey, Grace Berger's playing in the WNBA. She didn't get
okay.
Cut.
So we mean just as long as you on a team.
You are Kate Martin's playing, Grace Berger's playing. Yes, it's hard to win to make the league. Obviously, right? You know that. So, how many people on the current Iowa roster, the 13 scholarship players, would you say end up playing to some extent in the WNBA in the future?
Oh, Lord. This is a fantastic question, mind you, because there's so many variables. Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm.
Can I tell you what I think the easy answer is?
Go ahead.
I think the easy answer would be to say two.
Because who's your two?
I think Hannah Stolke's probably got maybe the most potential. And then Lucy Olson, just because of her ability to score.
Those are definitely much. in my two, but
maybe Sydney.
Hannah got to do. She got to. She has to develop a jump shot.
I agree. Yeah.
Or something. She has to do. She got to do something because she's not big enough to just be in the paint 24/7.
Or she's just got to turn into an elite rebounder for her size.
Something. Yeah. Something. We gon' yeah. But she got some time. Right.
She's got
how many years she got left?
I believe she's got 2 years.
Oh, okay, yeah, she got time.
She got 2 years.
Okay. I was like, Lord, she got time, right? Okay, so yeah. And then Lucy Olson, I think she probably will.
But we've also never seen her play.
A wild card for me.
We've never seen Lucy Olson play in an Iowa uniform, but she's, you know,
she's played Division I basketball at a high level. So
yeah, so Sydney potentially, someone like Kate Martin, like
she
Kate Martin
can remind me of like a Lexi Holt, okay. Right? Like she's gonna be able to guard because she's big, she's, you know, solid. Yeah. She can rebound, she can shoot the three a little bit. She's a hustle player. Like I could see her potentially transitioning into something like that. But last year was really the first year she really played half the season. Okay. I don't even know if we're going to go half the season. It was less than that. So I'm only going on what the little bit we were able to see. That's why I said she's a wild card because I haven't even got a full year of her yet.
Couple names.
But I can see some tangibles.
Couple names to watch for the future, potentially. I'll give you Ava Hyden, the big from Oregon.
I'm very curious about her.
Sneak preview from Media Day, but I know Coach Jay is very high on her, and she's been working with Randy Peterson since she was hired to the staff. And, of course, Coach Jay is a big – yeah, absolutely, post coach. And then
that's a post coach, always a post coach. I don't care if you become a head coach. She's still a post coach.
And then after her – I could name a couple different people for a couple different reasons. Like Aaliyah Guyton's got great blood because her dad, AJ, was a great player who was an All-American for Bob Knight, played in the NBA. Her mom was a pro player for Brazil. And, you know, Taylor Strimlow, both her parents played college basketball, and she's had a nice quick start. Tegan Mullaney was complimented during Media Day today with her length. But again, that doesn't mean you're going to translate to the WNBA, and it's – this is still going to be a development process for these young freshmen. So, but I think the safe bet is probably say two or three. It'd be great if there was like five or six future ones because, hey, maybe. Wouldn't you love to be able to look forward and say, all right, we don't know where they're at, but we have five or six future WNBA players on the roster.
I don't know when the last time we had two drafted in the same class, if we ever have.
We just did.
No, I'm saying I'm talking about outside of those two. I don't think we've ever had that before.
Yeah. Well,
it's always been one, right? Like one at a time, like Kathleen Doyle and then Sam Logic and then Megan Gustafs. I feel like it was always one, 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 one. And then we got two in a class and I was like, yay. So I'll be, maybe that was a turn of the tide.
Kasheen, when were you drafted?
2011.
We're
that's what a round? Long time.
Second round?
That's a great question because I don't even remember anymore.
You don't remember when you were drafted?
Listen, do you know how long ago it was? It's 2024. It's like 13 years ago. Okay, let me think.
You want me to find out? I can find out.
Maybe I think it was in the third round. Because remember, I was coming off injury. I never wish that on anybody, by the way. Coming off of injury into your senior year is not fun. Don't do
26th overall.
There you go.
Third round.
It was one of those.
Yep.
Minnesota Lynx. Love that. But yeah. So I hope it's two. Well, technically speaking, how many years does Olsen have left?
This is her. She's got 1 year.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Well. Ooh. So she should be very hungry. I like that.
Yeah, and she's gonna play a lot. They need
her. Yeah, you got 1 year.
She's gonna have her. She's gonna have
a good choice by her.
She's gonna have her hands on the ball a lot.
Listen, that was a great choice by her. Great choice.
Great choice by Iowa. If they didn't have her, wow.
Like, yeah, I mean, if you think about it, right? Mutually beneficial because she knew that Iowa had a very big hole.
Sure.
And then on top of that, she also needs to prove to the scouts what she's capable of doing against big time competition.
She made the comment today as we were chatting with her. She said she loves Iowa and she almost wish she said she, I wish I had been here for the last 3 years. And then she kind of caught herself. She's like, no, I love Villanova. I love Villanova, but she's like, I love Iowa. Iowa Nice is a real thing. And so she is genuine. She's loving it here.
That's why nobody really transfers.
Great point. No, I mean, it's great. It's a great point. And whether it's Jan or whether it's under Lisa's direction, I think it's almost one and the same. But here's one other takeaway I'll give people. I'm spoiling all my takeaways, but Coach Jay brought up at Big Ten Media Day last week that she was asked, what's the biggest difference between how you coach, what Coach Bluder stands for? And she basically said, you know, we're very similar. She did mention, though, we're going to have a few defensive wrinkles that are. So just
fun.
So that's how that's interesting. I actually brought it up to a couple of people today. One person I actually brought it up to is Taylor McCabe. She said that they're rebounding the ball a lot better than they ever have. And like they're working really hard to box out harder than they ever have in the past, which I thought was just on key for this conversation, given the fact that you were a rebounding machine as a guard. So that's something that'll help if they can they can rebound the ball better. You know, that's going to help.
That is very helpful.
So, Kasheen, always good to chat with you. And this is kind of like our warm up, the appetizer to talking hoops with you, hopefully for the months ahead. And I know you're busy with, how's your volleyball season going?
It's good. We're 4-0 right now.
All because of you?
No, but I'm a very large part.
No, but I'm a large part. Yeah.
I'm going to go live one day and put my phone up on Facebook and for one of my games. Cause I think people think I'm kidding when I say I'm really playing volleyball. It's not like old people volleyball either, folks.
You know,
the funny ones out there.
We can stream it on the YouTube channel. We can say Kasheen plays.
You know what? Volleyball, I have videos. There's one of the guys I play with, like open gym volleyball. He has like all of our stuff on YouTube, and I'm like, Nobody knows this league, so it's fine. But like,
you're going to tell me the name of this league. I read that you were really good back in high school. Could you have played college volleyball?
I could have. Junior year, I had to decide between club volleyball or AAU because it's a very important time. And I chose AAU. So, and then after Iowa, I was going to play my fifth year for Iowa volleyball, but then I got drafted. So there was that. Didn't do it. But yeah, it would have been fun. I love volleyball as a sport. It's a fantastic retire sport. Just saying.
Absolutely. Yeah, I don't know what I was going to say. This is going to be fun to be able to chat with you about this team. This is a new era. I mean,
yes.
So many different fronts, not just with the change at the helm, head coach, but also so many new faces, you know, as you walk in the arena today. And a lot of players coming off injury, unfortunately, but it sounds like everybody, knock on wood, is on track to be ready to go in November. But it's going to be a project. Coach Jay made that clear today, so